RHS Pre-Calculus presents Tony Hawk and the Mighty Jump. The goal of this presentation is to show the application of the law of sines.
Champion skateboarder Tony Hawk is preparing for the biggest jump of his life.
Yeah, I can't believe I'm doing this.
He needs to know at what angle the ramp is so that he can prepare and make the best jump. He also needs to know the height so he knows how high he is when jumping off the ramp, and the area of the triangular ramp to put up his logo.
And how do I do that?
Well, let's see what we already know. Know that one of the angles is 76 degrees, one of the sides is 21 feet, and the actual ramp is 34 feet.
We know two side lengths and one angle, which classifies it as an SSA triangle. To make it more understandable, we labeled all the angles A, B, and C, and all their opposite sides A, B, and C.
First, we need to know the height. That can be done by doing the simple equation of the formula sine of A equals H over B. So plugging in the values we already know, sine of 76 degrees equals H over 21. At this point, we work backwards. Multiply both sides by 21, and then we get H equals 21 sine of 76 degrees. Plugging that into the calculator, we will get H equals 20.38
feet. 20.38
feet?
I've never jumped that high. I think I'm going to be sick.
With an SSA triangle, it is possible to have 0, 1, or 2 triangle possibilities. But now that we know that the height is smaller than the two known sides, we know that there is only one triangle possible.
Now we can use the law of sines. A over sine of A equals B over sine of B.
Plugging in the numbers that we know, 34 over sine of 76 degrees equals 21 over sine of B. We can use cross multiplication to get rid of the fractions. 21 times sine of 76 degrees equals 34 times sine of angle B. At this point, we can solve for B by dividing both sides by 34. This gives us about 0.6 for sine B. Now to solve for B. Find the arcsine of B, which is 36.82
degrees. 36.82
degrees?
Wow, I need a really big protractor.
Now we need to find the area of the whole triangle so Tony can put up his logo.
To do that, we can use the formula area equals 1/2 times A times sine of angle C. We need to find the measure of angle C. That can be done by subtracting the measures of angle A and B from 180, because a triangle has a total angle measure of 180 degrees.
C equals 180 degrees minus 36.82 degrees minus 76 degrees. Therefore, C equals 67.18 degrees.
Plugging this into the formula along with the other variables, we get area equals 1/2 of times 34 times 21 times sine of 67.18 degrees. Therefore, area equals 329.06 feet squared.
Wow, that's a big logo. Okay, thanks everyone for the help. Now I have to go jump.